Доброе утро. This is our last video in which we're going to finish talking about denominative and prepositional cases. And this is what we've discussed so far. When we take nouns, people, places, things, nouns, and use them in sentences without any change, just like the way they're presented in dictionaries, we say that in our sentences, those words are in nominative case. In simple words, it just means no change has been made. These words answer questions кто, что, and they usually appear in the subject position in the sentence. So, for example, college. When we take nouns, and again, people, places, things, and we use them in sentences after prepositions на, something like on, or в, more like at, in, to provide information about place, location, and to answer the question где, where, in Russian we say these words are in prepositional case, after preposition, easy to remember. Nominative case is easy to remember as well because, I don't know if you can see name in it, nombre, if you know Spanish, it names the person or thing or place that you're discussing in your sentence, so usually subject in the sentence. And prepositional case for nouns that appear after a preposition, на, or в, to answer the question where, где, to talk about location. Most nouns have е ending once you put them after в or на. So right now, college is in prepositional case because it's after the preposition, е ending, talks about place, answers the question где. So right now, I would like to draw your attention to this bullet point. Most nouns in prepositional case have е ending. Please notice this most. There are a couple of exceptions, not many. So I want to show you something. If you wanted to ask where Anna is, где Анна, and we do stretch that N when we say it, где Анна, let's say she's at the college. So Анна в колледже. The minute I added в before the word college to answer the question где, I need to add the е ending. And since this is a masculine word, just adding е to it, and that's it, Анна в колледже. Let's say this time she's at the library, где Анна. Анна в библиотеке. So since this is a feminine word, has already the ending position taken, I need to get rid of this R first before I can add my new ending. So библиотека, dropping A, replacing it with Е. Анна в библиотеке. If you say Анна в библиотека without any change here after V, Russians will know what you're saying, but that's wrong grammar. We're teaching you proper grammar so that you could express yourself very well, and you could understand people when they speak Russian. Училище. So this is like a vocational school. They say it's similar to college in your book. Not really, because you can't take general education classes there and transfer to university or college. So for our school, College of Southern Nevada, please use college. But if you had a word ending in year, and you need year ending after V, so you kind of drop year, replace with year, no change really happens here. Анна в училище. So still follows the rule, most nouns have year ending after preposition в or на, talking about place. Let's say this time Анна is in California. So the sentence will look like this, Анна в Калифорнии. And this is one of the exceptions. When you have a word that in the dictionary form ends in ия, notice how the ending here is ия. So we say nouns have one letter endings, but it's easier for these words to remember ия because that's something we'll be using in the future as well. So ия words in prepositional case take ии ending, в Калифорнии. So the minute I added в, the ending changed to ии, в Калифорнии. And this time let's enter to Siberia, Сибирь. So this time it will look like this. I'm going to drop the soft sign and replace it with E. This is the second exception. E words change to EE after V. Soft sign words, drop the soft sign, take E instead, and everything else will have E ending. So here is the summary. Nominative case, just dictionary form of words in your sentence for the subject position usually. Prepositional case, to answer the question where, где, after prepositions N and V. And if you don't have soft sign, that changes to E, E changes to EE, then all other nouns will have E ending. Это все. До свидания.